we present Masters India, John Masters' saga of the Savage family from 1825 to 1946. The Deceivers, which has been dramatized by David Wade, is set in India in 1825 and features David Collings as William Savage. Episode 1, The Grave at Badora.
Death comes like a bolt of lightning. The strangler's cloth or rumal whirls around the victim's neck and into the left hand. With ferocious effort, then, he jerks his wrists together, and as he does so, drives a knee into the other's back. A bone goes crack. The victim falls down sideways, lifeless, eyes bolted in the head.
Do not be troubled. Fear not. No man dies by the hand of man. It is all at the will of Kali. All that the covenant that is between Kali and her servants be remembered.
Yea, in the time that followed the creation came Raktabij Danava, the demon of blood and seed, and he began to slay all created men. Then Kali went out to destroy the demon, and she struck him with her sword. But where his blood and seed ran down and dropped upon the earth, there sprang up fresh demons, and from their blood and seed yet more. And so it continued. Then Kali rested and wiped the sweat from off her blue-black body with a napkin, and lo, two drops of her sweat fell upon the ground, and on the instant they became two men. Then Kali said to them, "Take my napkin, my rumal, and with it strangle the demons, so that no drop of their blood and seed shall fall upon the earth." And they did as Kali had commanded them, so that all the demons perished. For that cause did Kali bequeath her rumal to the children of her sweat, and to their children's children for all generations, that killing they might live by it, and living for her honor kill.
William Savage, Englishman, servant of the great queen beyond the seas, hear me, for I am greater than she. Look on me, for I am lovelier than she. Take what is in my hand. Say now after me, Goddess, with this rumal I thee wed.
Goddess, with this rumal I thee wed.
With my body I thee worship.
With my body I thee worship.
With all the deadly craft and knowledge of my hands I thee endow.
With all the deadly craft and knowledge of my hands I thee endow.
O William, beloved of Kali, I await you. You shall be great among my servants.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here together in the sight of God and in the face of this congregation to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted of God in the time of man's innocency, signifying unto us the mystical union that is betwixt Christ and his church.
Mystical union. What about the utterly mysterious union that's betwixt me, William Savage, 41 next birthday, and this quite beautiful young woman here beside me, apparently of her own free will?
Not by any to be enterprised nor taken in hand unadvisedly, lightly or wantonly, to satisfy man's carnal lusts and appetites, like brute beasts that have no understanding, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, soberly, and in the fear of God.
Is anyone advised or sober who marries his superior's one and only child? Look at me. Captain William Savage, servant of the Honourable East India Company, collector. A very inefficient collector for Madhya district. And look at him, my impending father-in-law, Benjamin Wilson, agent of the Governor-General of India for Kaimur Mahadeo territories. I mean, why did Mary do it? Everybody knew she had married George. George included. Instead of which, here am I, and here's George Angelsmith with all his gold angelic curls and splendid English confidence, my own best man. It makes no sense. It's so hot.
William,
you've forgotten the ring.
No, we all know it's hot. Please don't wipe your hands on your trousers.
Therefore, if any man can show any just cause why they may not lawfully be joined together, let him now speak or else hereafter forever hold his peace.
Well, come on. Speak up, my fellow countrymen. You're all against it. Don't think I can't hear you now.
My dear, why doesn't Mr. Wilson speak? If ever I saw a father who didn't want to give his
really
girl away.
Savage's best uniform. Angelsmith quite shames him.
If I were poor dear Mary, I'd be sorry that I didn't snap up Mr. Angelsmith while I had the opportunity.
The question is, why didn't she?
Willfulness, my dear Major. Pure willfulness.
Well, inexperience. The girl's hardly been out here a year.
Why, the little minx. She told me she was born here.
Oh, so she was. But then her poor dear mother, God rest her, was obliged by her doctors to go home and took the infant with her. If she had had a mother to advise her, we'd be congratulating Mrs. Angelsmith, believe me.
If either of you know any impediment why ye may not be lawfully joined together in matrimony, ye do now confess it. For be well assured that so many as are coupled together, otherwise than God's word doth allow, are not joined together by God. Neither is their matrimony lawful.
Well, whatever else, you can't say my matrimony won't be lawful.
Wilt thou have this woman to thy wife?
Will it be anything
wife?
More, though?
Live together
friendly, loving, passionate. It will be on my side, but what about hers? Can she possibly love me? And if not, can I make her do so? But how? Oh, dear, the only joining I really know about is bits of timber. When it comes to matrimony, I've no idea. I wish I were at home at Madia now, in my workshop.
Captain Savage, would you like me to repeat the question?
What?
For God's sake, man, say I will.
Oh, I will.
Mary, wilt thou have this man to thy wedded husband to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Wilt thou obey him and serve him, love, honour, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all other, keep thee only unto him so long as ye both shall live?
I will.
Good morning to you, ladies.
Oh, good morning, Major. Where have the happy couple got to now, do you know?
Don't say dear Mr. Savage has mislaid himself again.
Not mislaid himself, ladies, no. But he did seem to be experiencing a certain difficulty in deciding which of his arms was which.
I can't think what you mean.
When last seen, he had his lady on his right and was trying to effect an exchange.
Really, a man can't do the correct thing at his own wedding. He hardly fill his bride with much confidence.
Particularly when he's old enough to be her father.
Ah, I think they're going to the carriage now.
I do apologise. I can't think
My dear, I don't mind which side you are, so long as you're one or the other.
Do get into the carriage, man, for God's sake.
There's no hurry, Father.
I'm so sorry,
sir. It's all perfectly all right.
Now, drive away, please.
There now. We're off.
Yes. Oh, my God, that was terrible. And the wedding breakfast still to come. Oh, well. It'll pass, I suppose. At least tomorrow we'll be riding down this very road and out of Sagtali, home to Madia. Just me and this amazing, radiant being, my wife. Except there'll be that blasted George the whole confounded way to Padua. Oh, damn!
Ah, morning, Savage. Nearly ready, I see.
Yes, sir. Yes, we're loading Mary's baggage now. Sherdil!
Sir?
The Memsahib's furniture doesn't look too safe to me.
Don't worry, sir. I have sent for more rope.
Oh, excellent. I'm hopeful we shall be away within the hour.
Well, no hurry. No hurry at all. In fact, as we have a moment, there are things I should like to say to you. Shall we walk this way?
Yes, by all means.
Our first... Please believe me when I say...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books,
Use the link in the video description.